Mrs. Shepherd, what story are you gonna read us today?
Well, well, let's see what we have. What is a friendship? How does it occur? What trials can true friendship overcome? From this story, you will learn how a young magician met a young inventor and how they created their first brotherhood.
Bye, Mom!
Study well, and don't blow anything up there, Folly.
Someone made a camp here. Why the goblin is my cinder lying here? Wow, it fit! This means that this is the camp of that poor guy from the canyon.
what's all the noise here? Mr. Fulner Vogro.
Here we go.
Mr. Vogro, you're skipping class again. Does your mother know you're not at school?
Yes, you see, I am now intensively preparing a project for the school fair.
The project must be completed outside of school hours. It is not for your creation you decided to disassemble the fountain, I hope. Mr. Vogro, I think you're taking me for a fool.
No, sir. What are you talking about?
I will definitely talk to your mother. Since you are so inquisitive and love mechanisms, you'll have to please fix the fountain. All the necessary parts are in the barn. When you're done, you're welcome to your lessons. Do you understand, young man?
Yes, sir. It will be done.
Tough luck.
Now I also have to repair the fountain. Okay. The teacher gave me a key to the barn, though. Whew, he's gone. Well, I didn't find... There it is! My key! Where did it fall? Finally, I have the key. Let's go to the shelter. What can you do, my friend?
Fulner pulled the first lever. Two stones were connected. Lightning struck. Then Fulner connected the other two stones, and the apparatus emitted a frosty cloud.
What if...
Then he decided to connect all the stones at the same time. The cave rumbled after the explosion, causing the stone wall with ancient inscriptions to crack.
Oh, my head! What an explosion! Oh no!
Wow.
It's falling! Thank you. who's there?
Fulner, take me with you.
Mora, you scared me. What are you doing here? How did you even find my shelter?
Can you guess? I figured out long ago where you were running away from home. Who do you think took your key? I wanted to use it, but I got angry when I realized that there should be two keys. And I hid the first one in the schoolyard.
Oh, you little. I had to fix the fountain because of you. What's more, Dornord will tell our mother everything.
I'll also tell Mom about your shelter if you don't take me with you.
Dang it! Okay, stay close. I don't know what kind of place this is or who might dwell here.
What are you going to do?
This is a forge, Mora. All dwarves are blacksmiths, in some way. know yet, but I think we activated something. Look! Something changed in the sarcophagus.
Fulner pushed back the lid of the sarcophagus with an effort. The darkness in the temple thickened, and a mysterious whisper came.
What is this? Fulner? I'm afraid.
The open sarcophagus revealed a skeleton with a large, beautiful dagger on its chest.
This knife is beautiful. The treasure hunter was probably writing about this treasure in his notes.
Folly, please, let's get out of here.
The children grabbed one another's hands and ran as fast as they could from the dark dungeons.
Wait, wait! I can't run anymore. What was that, Fulner?
I don't know, but it was scary.
Please, let's go home already.
Of course, Mara.
What happened here? Why is everything broken? Was there a tornado?
Mom? Where are you? I hope Mom is in the house.
Sorts of things like that.
Physics. Exactly. Thank you, Mora. The backyard is also devastated. However, the gate and the door are closed. Nobody went through the power multipole. Today I read about it in a textbook. A device.
done, Fulner.
The door's locked from the inside, but I don't have the key.
You forgot that we always keep a spare... Mother?
Mom, are you okay?
She seems to have a fever.
Look, she's holding some kind of note in her hand. Hang in there, Mom. We'll get everything done. So...
My head is still in a fog. But I feel better now. Thank you, my darlings.
Mom, who was here?
It was some kind of unknown beast. But I couldn't see it. It was as fast as lightning. As soon as I turned around towards the sound, it was no longer there. It was always ahead of my vision. It was so scary.
Shh, Mom. There's no danger anymore. We're with you.
Weren't you hurt, my children?
No, we were just...
At school. Mora visited me there, and then we returned home together. Never mind. Mom, I have to catch this beast before it causes even more trouble. Where did it go?
I don't know for sure, but the last noise I heard came from the western gate. I think it went to the ancestral rock. Son, this is very dangerous.
Since Father joined our ancestors, I have to protect our family. Mom, please give me the key to the closet. I need a seal from my father's crypt.
Why?
It's time to take my father's hammer. Mora? What happened here? It all makes sense. The poor guy started digging and caused an avalanche. It looks like this guy and his horse slipped down with a piece of the road. That's sad. What's happening? Oh my. Trevor, I found the treasure. Our family's crypt. Father is buried in the crypt along with his grandfather's hammer. What does it mean to honor the memory? Oh no! The school was also attacked! I hope Mr. Dornard and the students were not harmed. What? I did it! I hope I didn't mix anything up and grew what I needed. Hello, Aunt Lo. Your Circo is still with us. Hello, Grandfather. Today, I will put your hammer to work. You'll like it. Hello, Grandma. Miss you. Hello, Uncle Beebe. How are you? Hello, Father. Long time.
Fulner bravely stepped out of the dungeon, holding his father's hammer. Suddenly, a bunch of black smoke hit him in the back. Fulner has fallen.
What was it?
Was it a beast?
It's not a beast. What is it? You almost killed my mother.
The strange entity passed through Fulner and attacked him in the back again. Fulner began to lose strength. Before losing consciousness, he saw a mysterious figure of the man who attacked the entity with magic.